And a lot of people will be camping this holiday weekend, and that means campfires.
Emily Deem is live at the Shawano County Park Campground with more. Hi, Em.
The smoke follows me wherever I go, Rachel and Pete, no matter which way. And I think I got some in my eyes this morning, too. And I was going to say, you know, it's not a campfire without s'mores, and I wanted to roast some marshmallows this morning. A lot of people will be out this weekend enjoying a nice campfire, maybe doing a little camping, or even in their backyard. John Lubbers with the DNR is here with me this morning, and we want to talk about fire safety. You know, you want to have fun, you want to get outdoors, but you also want to be safe. Let's talk about the proper ring for maybe someone if they're having a campfire outdoors.
Sure. Well, that's one of the first things. You want to make sure you've got a good, safe site. And this is a perfect campfire ring. It's a good, solid metal ring. It's not got any cutouts or anything that could allow flames or sparks to escape from it. It's also surrounded by, you know, green, short grass, so that, you know, any sparks that jump out of there are not going to catch on fire. So if you don't have a green, short grass, you at least have some mineral soil, dirt, or gravel outside your fire ring to make it safe in case any sparks do jump out and that sort of thing. So a good, safe campfire ring, maybe it's metal or even rocks, would work.
And I know we're talking about the firewood. You want people to buy it locally.
Yes, we'd prefer people to buy their firewood locally to minimize the spread of bugs and diseases and that sort of thing, because we do have threats like emerald ash borer and gypsy moth and things like that that can be spread on firewood.
Okay. As I'm roasting my marshmallows, I wanted to catch a little bit of the flame because we're going to show how to properly put out the fire, too. Because even though you have one, you enjoy it, you can't just leave it when you're done for the night.
That's right. You know, we always want to make sure the fire is attended. And then when you are done with your campfire, you need to put it out. You can't just go to bed and expect it to be out, or you can't leave and go fishing and expect your campfire to stay where it is, because they can escape when you're not there.
What do you have here then?
So I've got a bucket of water. Maybe you've got a garden hose at your house or your cabin. Use that. But I've got a bucket of water here. I got a shovel. I got a rake here to help me, you know, put this fire out when I'm ready.
Okay. So. Are you ready? Wait, let me get a little more flame.
Yep. Get your marshmallows done.
Marshmallows nice and dark. All right, John, you go ahead.
All right. So.
As he's working, I'm going to enjoy my marshmallow because, I mean, he's the pro, doing a good job.
So you want to stir it around. Make sure that water has gotten to everything that's in there, and that's a lot of steam that's coming up from that fire, and that's what you're seeing there. And then just
keep monitoring, because even though it looks out to us, there may still be some hot spots in there.
Yep, and you can see there's a lot of good water in there and everything, you know, mixing it around and making sure all those coals and ashes have been drowned and wet.
Wonderful. John, thank you so much. Yeah, we want everyone to have a safe Memorial Day weekend. And we're out here at the Shawano County Park. We're going to be checking out the campground. We're going to be along the beach. It's an absolutely perfect day. Look at the folks already getting out there on Shawano Lake doing a little fishing. We're going to have more for you in just a little bit. We'll send it back to you.
Fantastic.